Hello students, in this video of ours we are going to learn about the crop production and management. This is the first chapter of your 8th science NCERT, crop production and management. Now you must be wondering why this crop production and management and all this agriculture things have come in the science textbook. Because agriculture, the management, the production can be improved with the help of science. Now, with the help of science, we can improve the yield of our field. We can improve the quality of our crop, knowing the type of the soil, knowing the nutrients required by the crop, knowing the cropping, different cropping patterns. We can improve the yield of our crop. Crop production and management, and that is why this chapter is there in your science textbooks, the very first chapter, because if you are using science, the knowledge of science in the field of agriculture, you are getting good yield, you are getting good quality of crops, you are getting disease resistant varieties, having resistance for the environmental stresses, climatic stresses. So all these things comes into the agriculture with the help of the knowledge of science. So first let us know how this is the crop is produced and how we can manage it. What is agriculture? Agricultural practices we are going to do in this chapter. But before that, let us understand what is agriculture. Till 10,000 BC, people were nomadic. Nomadic means they used to wander from here to there. They were not settled at one place because they were depending on the fruits and raw vegetables and fruits and the meat of different animals for their food. And they were roaming here and there. There were no clothes. There were no proper food to eat. So they were roaming. They used to wandering in groups from place to place in search of food and shelter. They ate raw fruits and vegetables and they started hunting for animals for food. Later they could cultivate land. Then suddenly they discovered that they can cultivate land and produce food on a piece of land. And they started growing plants. And this is how the agriculture was discovered. And this is how the agriculture came into existence. Now, agricultural practices, first of all, we should understand what is a crop. What is crop? Crop is when plants of the same kind are grown and cultivated at one place on a large scale. It is called a crop. That means when you are growing one or two plants in your garden, that is not crop. What is crop? Crop is when you are growing the same kind of plant on a large area for the commercial purposes, and that is called crop. For example, crop of wheat means that all the plants in the field are of wheat. That is called crop. Now, you already know that crops are of different types, like cereals, vegetables, fruits, pulses. So in cereals we have wheat, bajra, maize, jaw. All these things are comes in cereals. Then vegetables, fruits and pulses, all moong, chana, masoor, all these are pulses. So these can be classified on the basis of the, this is one type of classification, and another type of classification is on the basis of the season in which they grow. So on the basis of the season in which they grow, we can divide the crops into two, kharif crops and rabi crops. The crops which are sown in the rainy season are called kharif crop. Rainy season means from generally from June to September, because that is the rainy season in India. So the crops which are grown in that season rainy season, it is called kharif crop. And example are paddy, maize, soybean, groundnut, cotton, etc. These are all kharif crop. The second type of crop is rabi crop. Now, rabi crop is grown in the winter season. That means the period from October to March, because in India, we have winters from October to March. So that is called rabi crops. Example, wheat, peas, gram, mustard, linseeds. And the besides these, the pulses and vegetables are grown in summer season at many places. So other crops are also grown in India, but the two categories in which they can be divided are kharif and rabi crops. Now, what are the basic practices for crop production? First of all, we will see the production part, and then we will come to the management part. Production, in production part, we will see how the crop can be produced, how the good quality of crop can be produced. So for that, there are various agricultural practices. And first of all is preparation of soil. First of all, you have to prepare the soil of the piece of land where you want to cultivate your crop. And in this preparation, you have to remove the pebbles. You have to remove the weeds which are there, the grasses and all. Then you have to layer the soil. You have to mix the manure in it. You have to plow the soil, loose the particles of the soil so that the air can be trapped inside it. And then the soil is ready for sowing. And second agricultural practice is sowing. Then you have to add manure and fertilizers. Then irrigation. Irrigation is timely water supply to the crops. Then protecting your crop from the weeds. Weeds are the undesirable plants which grow on their own with your crop. So they are called weeds. We have to remove them because these weeds, they compete for life, they compete for nutrients with our main crop. So we have to remove them. Harvesting is when the crop is mature, then we have to cut the crop. That is called harvesting, and then it's storage. So these are the agricultural practices which a farmer has to follow for crop production. Now, first of all, we'll see how to prepare the soil. The preparation of soil is the first step before growing a crop. One of the most important tasks in agriculture is to turn the soil and loosen it. This allows the roots to penetrate deep into the soil. Why do we want to lose the soil? Because when we are losing the soil is having some spaces where the air can be trapped. And this air, the air is one of the requirements for the germination of the seed. For germination of seed, sunlight is required, nutrients are required, and then air is required. So when you are loosening the soil, the air can be available for the germinating seed. Number two, when the soil is loosened, it allows the roots to penetrate deep into the soil and help the plant to hold firmly to the ground. And in the loosened soil helps in the growth of microbes also, earthworms also. And these microbes and earthworms, they are farmers' friend because they are also helping in the loosening of the soil when they move. The microbes are there who are fixing nitrogen. They are present in the soil. They are fixing nitrogen for the plant. So they are making the soil more nutrient for the plant. So all these microbes and earthworms, they are friends of the farmer, and they add humus to the soil. What is humus? Humus is the organic matter, which can be excreta, which can be the dry leaves, which can be any organic matter. And this humus is present on the surface of the soil. So that humus increases the fertility of the soil, and the soil is rich. When the soil is rich in humus, it is all the more fertile for the plants. Now, the process of loosening and turning of the soil is called tilling or ploughing. And this tilling or ploughing is done with the help of a plow. So this is the diagram of a plow. You must have seen the bullock carts also. Bullock carts, the farmer use bullock cart also to plow the field. Or manually also the plow can be done. The plow can be used to plow the field. Now this is done by using a plow. Plows are made up of wood or iron. If the soil is very dry, it may need watering also before plowing. Because if the soil is very dry, then it is difficult to plow the soil without putting water in it. The plowed field may have big pieces of soil which are called crumbs. So it is necessary to break these crumbs. Because if the crumbs are there, then the seed will not be able to germinate in it. So for the seed to germinate, the soil should be separate, the particles should be separate, it should be loose and smooth, and these crumbs should be broken down into small particles with the help of a plank. So this is a plank. Now what are the different agricultural implements before we use for the agricultural practices? Before sowing of seeds, it is necessary to break the soil to the size of grain to get better yield. Because if we want a good yield, then the soil should be loosened enough, the particles should be small enough. And this is done with the help of the various tools. The main tools are plow, cultivator, OA, and these are the tools which are used for loosening of the soil. See, this is the farmer is using the bullock cart to plow the field. The plow is being used since ancient times for tilling the soil, adding of manure, removing of weeds, scanning of the soil, etc. So all this is done with the help of the plow. Strong. Now what does a plow has? It has a strong triangular iron strip called plow shear. The main part of the plow is a long log of wood and with a stand which is called shaft. There is a handle at one end of the shaft. So there you can see the shaft, the plow shear and the handle. So what is OA? OA is a simple tool which is used for removing weeds and for loosening of the soil. It has a long rod of wood or iron. A strong, broad and bent plate of iron is fixed to one of its ends and they work like a blade. It is pulled by animals. So this is for the loosening of the soil. Now cultivator. Nowadays plowing is done by tractor as well, and this is tractor-driven cultivator. Cultivator is there fixed in the with the tractor, and when the farmer is moving the tractor, the plowing can be done. So use of cultivator saves labor and time. It can be done in less time. The time consumed is less and the energy consumed is also less because the farmer is not doing it manually. Farmer is doing it with the help of the tractor. Now comes the second practice, agricultural practice. Once your soil is prepared well, now it is ready for the sowing. Now sowing is one of the most important part of crop production because it all depends, the quality of plant depends on the quality of the seed. So first of all, you have to select good quality of seeds. So here comes the science. Now the good quality of seeds are selected. And you should be able to discriminate between the good quality and bad quality of the seed. And for your crop, you should select only the good quality of seeds. Good quality seeds are clean and healthy seeds of a good variety. Farmers prefer to use seeds which give a high yield. Before, good quality means not that the seed is shining on. The good quality means that the production would be good. The yield would be good. The plant would be disease resistant. The plant would be environmental stress resistant. So all these things should be there in a good quality seed. So before sowing, one of the important tasks is to know about the quality of the seeds. Now, how can we find out whether the seed is good or bad? It's simple activity is there. You have to take a beaker, fill half of it with water and put a handful of seeds which you are using. Here they have written wheat seeds. You can use any seeds and stir it well and wait for some time. Now what will happen? You will see that some seeds, they will just sink. They will sink and they will be at the bottom of the beaker, and some will float. So those who are floating on the water, they are lighter. They are lighter, and those who have sinked or those who are at the bottom of the beaker, they are heavier. So damaged seeds are also always lighter because they are hollow from inside. So that's why all damaged seeds would come on the surface and they will start floating. So you can differentiate between the good quality of seeds and bad quality of seeds, because if they are floating on the surface of the water, that means they are hollow from inside and they are damaged, and that's why they are lighter. So we should remove those seeds. We should not use those seeds for sowing. We should be using the seeds only who are at the bottom, because they are heavy and they are full. That means they are of the good quality. Now for sowing also, the traditional tool which is used is for sowing the seed is shaped like a funnel. The seeds are filled into that funnel and they pass down through two or three pipes having sharp ends, and these and purse the soil. That means they will go inside the soil and they will place the seeds there. So the tool which is used for sowing of the seeds is having a funnel like structure, and in that funnel you have to fill the seeds, and then these funnels are having pipes in them, and these pipes, they have the sharp ends, and these sharp ends will pierce into the soil, and when you put the seeds into that funnel, the seeds will be sown in the soil. And nowadays we are using this seed drill also for the sowing with the help of the tractors. So here also you are conserving the energy as well as the time. Yes, you can use the seed drill with tractor. So with the help of the seed drill, the seeds can be sown. And the advantage of the seed drill is that these seeds will be sown uniformly. Uniformly means at proper distances and depth. Why proper distance is required? Because every seed should get sufficient nutrient, sufficient sunlight, and there should not be any competition. So for that, there should be some distance between the plants. So the seeds should be sown at proper distances and proper depth also. Because if the depth is very deep, then the seed will not be sown, because the light sunlight cannot penetrate in, the availability of air is not there, so the seed will not germinate. And if the seeds are on the surface of the soil, then also they will be eaten up by the animals. So to avoid the damage of the seeds, we should sow them at the proper distances and proper depth. And this all can be ensured if we are using seed drills. These tools, they ensure that seeds get covered by the soil after sowing. And this prevents damage caused by birds. Because if the seeds are on the surface, they can be eaten up by the birds. And sowing by using a seed drill also saves time. Now, once you have sown the seeds, now you have to add the manure and fertilizer. Now these manures and fertilizers are added to the soil because they are the nutrients for the healthy growth of plants. Like we are eating fruits and vegetables because they are necessary for our healthy growth. Similarly, for the healthy growth of the plants, they need nutrients. and these nutrients can be supplied to them with the help of manure and fertilizers. Now, they supply mineral nutrients to the crop. These nutrients are essential for the growth of the plants. Continuous growing of crop makes the soil poorer in certain nutrients. Now, what happens? These nutrients are present in the soil, and soil has a capability to replenish itself after a certain time. But if we are sowing the crop continuously, year after year, season after season, then what will happen? That soil will become deficient in certain nutrients. So when the soil becomes deficient in nutrients, these nutrients are not available to the plant. And when these nutrients are not available to the plant cannot grow nicely. The healthy growth cannot be ensured. So to ensure the healthy growth of the plant, we should add manure and fertilizers in the soil for the plant. Now, therefore, farmers have to add manure to the fields to replenish the soil with nutrients. This process is called manuring. Improper or insufficient manuring results in weak plants. Suppose we have not added the proper quantity of the manure, and the manuring is not done properly. So, and the soil is not rich in the nutrients. So, that will result in the weak growth of our plants. Now, what are fertilizers? What is the difference between manure and fertilizers? Fertilizers are chemical substances which are rich in a particular nutrient. They are not having all the nutrients. They are nutrient specific, and they are rich in particular nutrient. They are the chemical substances. They are inorganic salts. They are produced in the factories. And the use of fertilizers also help farmer to get better yield of wheat, paddy or maize, whatever is the crop, because this fertilizer is having a nutrient specific substance. Suppose your soil is deficient in phosphate, so you can use the fertilizer which is having phosphate. If your soil is deficient in nitrogen, so the farmer can use the fertilizer which is having nitrogen. That's why the soil testing is done before sowing of the crop. Once you have tested the soil, you will come to know. These days the labs are there, and the farmer can take the soil sample of his field to the lab, and they will test the soil and let the farmer know that which nutrient is not in sufficient quantity in his soil. So the farmer can choose the fertilizer which should be used for that crop. But excessive use of fertilizers has made soil less fertile. Suppose you are using fertilizers indiscriminately. Whatever is the crop, you are using everything. You are using urea, you are using all kind of for chemical fertilizers. And what happens when the rain comes? They will be washed away to the nearby water reservoir. And what will happen in that water reservoir? Due to excess of fertilizers, the algae growth would be there. And the excessive growth of algae would not let other aquatic life, other organisms to have the oxygen, because this algae will cover the whole water surface, and that process is called eutrophication. And eutrophication is water pollution, because once the eutrophication has happened, the other animals which are below in the water, like fish, zooplanktons, so they will not get enough sunlight and sufficient oxygen. So because of the lack of proper quantity of oxygen in water, they will die. So this is a source of water pollution, eutrophication, if we are using chemical fertilizers indiscriminately in our fields. Rather, we should use manure. Now, what is the advantage of using manure? Manure is an organic material, organic substance, and which is made up of excreta of the cow, like cow dung, And so all these organic matter, they form the manure. And manure is considered better than the fertilizer because manure enhances the water holding capacity of the soil and it makes the soil porous due to which exchange of gases become easy. Porous means there are pores, there are spaces between the soil particles. When they are porous, the exchange of gases becomes easy. And the water holding capacity of the soil also increases when we are using manure. So we should be using manure, not fertilizers. But manure is not nutrient specific. Manure is having all the nutrients. So if our soil is deficient in one particular nutrient, in that case, we have to use fertilizer, but that fertilizer should be used by after proper testing of the soil. The manure increases the number of friendly microbes as well, because the manure will increase the growth of the microbes. Whereas the fertilizers, because they are chemical, they can stop the growth of the friendly microbes. And manures improves the texture of the soil as well. Differences: the fertilizer is an inorganic salt. Manure is a natural substance obtained by the decomposition of the cattle dung, human waste and plant residue. A fertilizer is prepared in the factories, whereas manure can be prepared in the fields. A fertilizer does not provide any humus to the soil, whereas manure provides a lot of humus to the soil and that will enrich the soil. And fertilizers are very rich in plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, whereas manure are relatively less rich in plant nutrients, but they are having all the nutrients in them and they are not giving any harm to the soil as well as to the plant, and as well as to the nearby water reservoirs. So that is the advantage of having manure. These days, there is organic farming is very popular. Now, what is organic farming? Organic farming is where we are not using any chemicals for the growth of the plant. We are using only manure and we are managing the pest also biologically. That means no pesticides, no insecticides, no chemical fertilizers, no chemicals are used for the growth of the plant. And that product is called organic product. You can go and visit the grocery shop nearby and you can find out that the organic pulse is costlier than the normal pulse, because organic pulse is the pulse, or organic grain is the grain which has been grown without using any chemicals. And that is called organic farming. So we'll continue with this chapter in our next video.